And these people here, man, these first responders, they lost their lives. These two brothers, first of all, go back to this picture right here for a minute. They didn't have to die. Tell somebody they didn't have to die. But we got a problem in America. Come on, somebody. We got an epidemic in America. And I believe it's because of what happened in 1963 when they took prayer out of school. What if those same babies were still in school praying? What if the first graders had a time to pray? What if second graders had a time to pray? What if the middle school kids had a time to pray? What if, I wish I had somebody to fulfill the preacher. What if high school kids had a time to pray? Because of Madeline O'Hara, prayer was taken out of school, and now we got people in police force or law office. Come on, somebody, who don't have a relationship with God. How are you gonna protect me if you don't know God? I need to be trying to protect you. I wish I had somebody that would shout amen. Anything can happen, man, when you leave the closet. So number two, we recognize that there is a problem. They, first of all, didn't have to die. Come on here, somebody. And now we got people who are bothered and upset, amen. But I believe that the first responders who were there, come on, somebody, talk to me. Tell your neighbor, they didn't have to die either. They were innocent in this whole thing. Come on here, somebody. Put yourself in their position. They're in an open carry state, which means in an open carry state, everybody out there got a gun. Come on, somebody. In an open carry state like Dallas, it's legal for everybody to carry a gun. And when bullets start flying and everybody got a gun, I don't know who's shooting at me. But if we get back in the prayer closet, I wish I had somebody that would talk to me. God will help us to know that we ain't gonna beat it by marching. We ain't gonna beat it by protesting. We got to deal with legislation. We got to get some laws passed. We got to get the city hall. I wish I had somebody that would jump up and sit back down and say, America has left the closet. America has come out of the closet. And we got to get back in the closet. Thirdly, we got to recognize I'm part of the problem. Do I have somebody here right now that would recognize I'm part of the problem? I know everything might be in your house okay right now, but what happens when things go bad in your house? See, if you don't see yourself as part of the problem, then neither are you going to see yourself as part of the solution. The only way we're going to get you involved is when you recognize it might not be my child today, but I got to recognize it's somebody else's child. Can I get somebody to holler to brother here right now? Lean on your neighbor and say, when you're going through, I'm going through too. When your house is in trouble, my house is in trouble too. Further, we got to see ourselves as part of the problem. All of us are in this thing together. All of our hearts were broken on last week. All of us were in mourning on last week. Why? Not because of the gun. Tell somebody, not because of the gun. No, some of you, we got guns in this church right now. Nobody have got shot in here, so it's not the gun. You got a gun in your house, some of you. But you don't walk in every few minutes to check on it, to make sure it's okay. Look at your neighbor and say, America has come out the closet. It's not the gun that's the problem. It's the unregenerated person. Hey, I wish I had somebody with the gun that's the problem. Somebody say amen. We got to get back in the closet, y'all. We got to get back in the closet. We have the moral fiber of our nation have been weakened, and now nobody trusts.